Biological control means thermophysiology, the fights against alien invasive plants is an ongoing process globally. The water hyacinth plant was introduced to South Africa as just a symbol of ornaments. It has since spread across the country, invading rivers and dams, and in so doing affecting water availability. It has negative impacts on ecosystem health and balance, meaning that humans are unable to benefit from services such as nutrient recycling and pollination. It is not all doom and gloom, as you can control the spread of invasive species through the process of biological control. Biological control is a cost-effective method, as it only requires the introduction of biological control agents into an infested area. However, the main obstacle with biological control methods is that of post-establishment success. More often than not, when agents are released to areas outside of their normal temperature range, they fail to establish, and this can be related to thermophysiology. Thermophysiology refers to temperatures that affect everyday functioning of all living organisms. To assess thermophysiology in my study, I looked at critical thermal limits as well as lethal limits. Critical thermal limits refers to ways in which temperature affects coordinated movements, whereas lethal limits refers to the temperatures at which populations are unable to recover after being exposed to thermal stress for a particular period of time. Organisms are able to established in areas outside of their normal thermal tolerance range through the process of thermal acclimatization. And this is what I was investigating in my study. Neocyanine coniae is a biological control agent that controls the spread of water hyacinth in South Africa. It is native to South America and has been the most successful ever since its release. Neocyanine coniae individuals were collected from two different sites in South Africa with varying climatic conditions. The first site is the Ensereni River in KwaZulu-Natal near Richards Bay, which is a relatively warm site. The second site is the Kubusi River in the Eastern Cape near Stasaheim, which is relatively cold and experiences frosting events during winter. I was testing for thermal acclimatization in both populations, and I did this by looking at the differences in the populations and sexes of Neocyanine coniae. There were no differences in the populations and sexes of the critical thermal limits. In contrast, there were differences in sexes and populations of the lethal limits. And this is because lethal limits are more intense than critical thermal limits, as they measure death instead of just behavioral modifications. Results from this study can be utilized by scientists, as they can conduct more thermal acclimatization studies on other biological control agents, and in so doing, enhance post-establishment success.